Hey guys, if you don't know me, my name is Brittany Wang. I'm an author of an upcoming YA fairy fantasy series, and today I am so excited to be unveiling my author website design to you as I also give you some great tips on creating your own. Now, obviously, if you already have books out in the world, your author website is vital because that is the place that people find out about you in your books in one central hub that you have complete control over. This way, you can connect with your readers no matter what social media outlets come and go. But what if you're like me and you don't have any books out yet? Is it worth going through all the trouble to create an author website? I'd say it really depends on how serious you are about your author journey. If you're serious about making it as an author, I would say it's really important to make at least a simple one-page author website as soon as you can. Not only will it look great to potential agents and publishers in the future, but if you use your website effectively, it can be one of the best ways to build anticipation for your books, find new readers, so that when you do publish those books, you already have an excited readership that is anxiously ready to buy and help promote your books. Now, there are many great videos here on YouTube already that break down all these different directions you can go in building your author website. But for me, as I wanted to give you some tips, I thought about what I would really enjoy, and when I came up with the answer, it was that I really wanted to see an example of someone's website and how they use it effectively. So I literally thought that I would bring you through the site I've created, show you what I've included, and how I'm using it to build my author platform even before my books are released. So whether you have an author website already and you're looking for some improvement tips, or you are wondering where the heck to start with creating an author website for the first time, let's jump into it. Well, guys, welcome to my author website, authorbrittanywang.com. You guys, I am so pleased with how this came out. If you're wondering, I chose to create my website with Wix.com. And I went this direction because Wix is so user-friendly. Everything is drag and drop, so no coding necessary. It has a multitude of templates you can start with and then customize to your heart's content. And the best part for me was that I could create an account and play around with as many different versions of my website as I wanted at absolutely no cost. Basically, at the time I'm recording this video, you can create a totally free, awesome looking website with a longer Wix URL that ends up being your username.wixsite.com/your site name, and you can totally use that and boom, you have a website for free. Or if you want to add your own custom URL, you can purchase a premium package starting at as little as $5 a month. I've been using Wix for years to create sites for myself and others, and they seriously just get better all the time, always improving and adding new features. So if you don't already have a website builder, or if you've been thinking about switching things up a bit, I would totally suggest checking them out yourself, and I'll also include the link to their website in the description below. Cool, so this is my homepage. And guys, homepages are super important because most people will look at a site for literally seconds before they decide if they're going to keep poking around or if they're just gonna click off. So for me, I started with my same branded colors I use on YouTube and all other socials. And you can see the links to all my socials in the top right corner over here. I've also made use of my Instagram photos, anybody that has seen me on Instagram, and I use it sort of as a banner, and people that have sort of beta tested my website before I've launched really liked that, and so do I. So I did that. Then you sort of see, obviously, my name, who I am, that I'm all about YA books, writing advice, and writing community. And then I have this quick about sort of snapshot with links, as you can see in here. So it just says basically who I am and some of the different things I offer. And as I hover over here, you can see that some of these things take me to different pages on the website or other links like my AuthorTube. I also have my newsletter sign up right under my about snapshot. And this is really important, maybe even more important than having a website, because this is how you continually stay connected with your readers. So here I'm offering get writing tips free resources, and my book updates straight to your inbox. And it's just a simple form where they fill out their name and their email and they can hit subscribe. What I love about Wix is it actually offers a newsletter mailing list feature right built into your website. And you can totally use a different service if you want, but I loved that this was included. And in a little while, I will show you what one of those emails looks like, but I thought that this was really great. Below my newsletter, you also see I have some featured things that I wanted to make sure anybody just willing to see the first page would see automatically. And you can see that I am telling people about my author tube, which is a really big part of my platform right now. And also the other big part is my writer's Facebook group. And guys, if you do not have a book out yet, because that would obviously be featured here if you did, I would strongly suggest that you have some other things to offer to get people connected and allow them to get to know you and what you're all about and offering them some kind of value. So again, I'm sharing writing tips on my author tube, and I'm also cultivating writer community through my Facebook group. And these buttons here just take us directly to those things, which is pretty awesome. One last thing before we move on is I just wanted to say that before even publishing this whole full-on website, I did use Wix to create free one-page landing pages that provided free downloads, free resources in exchange for people to sign up for my newsletter. And I did this even before I had a plan of what I was going to share in my newsletters, but I just knew that it was important. So here's a little preview of what those look like. And guys, now that I'm launching my website, even before I get going, I already have over 200 subscribers from offering those free resources. So just a power tip there. And if you get intimidated by the magnitude of what I might have on this website, what I really want you to hear is if you do nothing else, create that one page author website where you're sharing a little bit about yourself, a little bit about your books, but then ultimately offering some kind of content, some kind of resource or downloadable that you can offer in exchange for them signing up for your newsletter. And finally, at the bottom of my website, you can see that I have the newsletter sign up one more time, which will show up on every single page. So if you couldn't tell already, the newsletter thing, pretty darn important. Also, I just wanted to show you real quick that Wix makes it so easy to also make a mobile friendly version of your site. As you create your desktop site, Wix will automatically add everything you put on your desktop site to your mobile site, and then you can still adjust it further to make it even nicer if you would like. So here you can see the homepage and how it looks very similar, but it's just a lot more readable for mobile. And up here we've got the menu, which looks really nice and is really user-friendly. And then I really love this feature you can add here as well, which is just a button that takes them directly to be able to contact you or your other socials. So it's just really pretty, really clean, and I love it. Back to the desktop site, you can see next in the menu is this About button. And you can see there's one that's called Brittany, which is sort of my bio in longer length than the snapshot that was on the first page, and then my blog. And I'm gonna go into both in a second, but I just wanted to say that I'm a little undecided whether I want the blog to remain here or be at the top menu. I got some feedback that it should be up at the top here, but I just really didn't want the menu to be too cluttered. And the reason for that is because people can only take in so much. And so if you have too many things up on the menu bar, then people will just get confused and not know what to click and get disinterested. So for right now, my blog is living under the About section, but that might change. And what I love about Wix is it just makes it really easy to sort of shift things around and change if I want to in the future. So if we click on Brittany, or if we click on the Learn button over here under my little About snapshot, it takes us to my longer bio. And I sort of go more in depth here. First, I have a little, again, snapshot. This is in third person for people that might want to interview me or talk about me in the future. And so that's really quick for them. But then I went a little more personal in first person and told a little bit more about my story as an author, my history. And again, you can see I have a few links in here as well to direct people afterwards to other things that they might be interested in. And this is another thing that I would just really suggest is putting links, maybe not as many as I have, I tend to have a lot, but putting links sort of sprinkled throughout your website, not just on your menu, because people want to know where to go next. And not a lot of people are just going to go through every single part of your site. You sort of want to help guide them to where they would like to go. And so you can see that I have a link for helping other writers. So anybody interested in that would click that, or the community, the writers community here, or if they wanted to check out my AuthorTube channel, or they wanted to contact me, or go read more about my books, they would just have that direct connection. This way you're just helping people along and keeping them excited and engaged on your website. Now let's travel over to my blog. And here, Wix has many different templates that you can choose from, and it makes it super easy to create and manage your posts. And as you can see here, again, if you're familiar with my Instagram, you'll recognize these pictures. I have been playing with the idea of taking some of my content on my Instagram descriptions, which I tend to share a lot of great content, and sort of transpose them into longer blog posts. And I'm thinking of doing this as well, because on Instagram, they're sort of live and exciting for a small amount of time, and then they quickly disappear into the back of your feed. And I'm sharing all this content that I would love to just live for longer and be more helpful. And so I'm playing around with that idea. Obviously, I will also create other blog posts as well that are not on Instagram, but I just thought that that would be really helpful for me so I don't have to create so much extra content. But if you're wondering about if you should have a blog or not, in my research, I've found that it is really great for your website because it adds so many words that end up being keywords for Google. So if you've heard about SEO and sort of the search terms and how people find your website at all, it is through usually Google. And so having content on your blogs and having those searchable terms really helps your website show up in search. Now, if we click on one of these articles, you can sort of get a snapshot of what it looks like and how you can format it. People can like the post, they can share it, they can comment on it. And then all the way at the top here, you can also tag all of your posts with categories. And how these categories work is, say I click on writing advice, now you see all of my posts with writing advice. If I click on my writing, people want to just see posts about my writing and my books, then it just shows articles that have to do with that. Same with writing community and Camp NaNoWriMo. So categories can be really great for your viewers as well. Next, obviously, you should have a books page. And for people that already have books out, this is where they would go, obviously. Wix even has a store feature included in one of the premium packages, so you can sell books and signed books directly from your site, or you can just put images and descriptions of your books and then include links to Amazon or wherever your books are sold. Now, if you're like me and you don't have any books out yet, I would suggest doing something like this. As you can see here, first I have a little bit about my current WIP, which just simply says it's a YA fantasy, and then it has my current pitch. And if people want to learn more, they can also click that button that says sign up for my newsletter. Surprise, surprise. And also I've included a little aesthetic to give a mood and sort of a taste of what the characters might look like. So that's been fun. And then secondly, I've put a little snippet of my writing style. And what I am excited that I get to put here is I actually won a micro story contest on Instagram a few months ago. And so I sort of added that in here with the story prompt that was in the post, and then my submission that I won with. So this page is actually accomplishing three different things for me, even though I have no books ready for purchase. It is saying, hey, I'm working on something and I hope you're excited about it. Then it is also showing a sample of what my writing is like, which is great for readers as well to see. And it is showing credibility with winning writing contests. So all of these things, again, will hopefully pull in my ideal reader and make them want to stick around for more. I also made sure to create this books page as I don't want my non-writing readers to feel like this whole site is just for writers. But at the same time, I did want my writing readers to have a space just for them. So I created my For Writers area. In the For Writers area, you can see that I have both one page called Writing Help and one page called Freebies. I could have just put Writing Help because the freebies are included in that, but I wanted to highlight that I do free downloads and free resources, so that's why I chose to put that there. But let's start with the Writing Help page. Here you can see that I've highlighted all the things that could help a writer that I offer, which again is my YouTube, my free downloads, which I'll show you that page in a second, my writer's blog, which links back to that page we saw before, my writer's Facebook group, which goes directly to Facebook, and other resources, which is a list of all my favorite books on the craft of writing, as well as I'll eventually include different things, maybe like blogs and such. But as you can see here, you can click on any of these resources and I'll take you directly to Amazon where you can learn more and purchase. The other button that we haven't looked at yet as well is the free downloads or freebies section. And on this page, you can see that by signing up for my newsletter, anybody can access all of my free downloads and special offers, which include my series Bible templates, my Instagram live planning checklist, and more being added all the time. So again, if you've seen some of my other YouTube videos, I do some previews of my resources and how I use them, and then I send people to download those tip sheets or those checklists or those templates, and that will now take them to this page where they can sign up for my newsletter. And when they get my newsletter, it'll give them just a simple password. They don't have to create a username or their own password. They get my password, and that's going to allow them to see the members page, which I saw other authors do this on their pages. Bethany Atizada, Rebecca K. Sampson, and Jade Young were just a few of them, and I thought that this was genius. Instead of having all of these different emails with all of these different links to different resources, if they just click the members page, they'll have access to everything. So let's click what is a member, and that brings them to the members page. And it says becoming a member gets you access to all of my free downloads, special offers, live streaming schedule, book news, and first looks, and more. So at this point, again, if they haven't become a member yet, they can sign up or they can just click the members page. And so I'll just show you that real quick. I will click here and you'll see guest area. Please enter the password, and I will enter the password here. And when I click go, it opens up this members area. So this area was really fun to make, and I'm so excited for you guys to take advantage of this. It just says, congrats, you're a member. Get access to all my free downloads and special offers below. Watch this page and my newsletters for new content added regularly. So here for right now, I just have my series Bible templates and my Instagram live planning checklist, and I have the videos linked here that you can actually click and view right here. And it sort of gives you the preview of how to use these resources. And then as you can see here, you can download the resources by just clicking the buttons right here. As you can see right now, I pretty much only have resources for writers, but I am also planning to add like my book cover and first chapters here. And so people can get first looks and maybe even vote on things, and it'll just be more interactive and be for both readers and writers. So I'm really excited about this. And finally, we should always have a simple contact page. So it says, don't be a stranger, drop me a line, I'd love to hear from you. And they can just fill this out with their name, email, and message, and they hit submit and it'll send it directly to my email.
Well guys, if you enjoyed taking a tour through my author website, I hope you'll give this video a like, and if it inspired you to do some work on your own author website, I would love to know that, or if you have any other questions, let me know that in the comments. If you would like to see more of this step-by-step process of how you can create your own author website with Wix, I have been thinking about doing a couple videos on that. So if that's interesting to you, also let me know that in the comments and I will make that happen. In the meantime, of course, I would love if you would actually go visit my author website. I will link it in the description below. And I hope you'll consider signing up for the newsletter so you get access to all of my free goodies in the members area, and you'll be the first to see sneak peeks and hear updates about my upcoming fantasy series. As always, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit that bell so you don't miss any weekly writerly videos. And until next week, happy writing.